Welcome to the Liquid Nitrogen Kitchen.
Hello.
This is our second episode. And last time we did some coffee. And today we are going to make healthy smoothie with liquid nitrogen. And then we test, can you warm up liquid nitrogen using electric kettle and make some tea or something. Which one we do first?
Smoothie.
Yeah, yep. Smoothie. So idea is to put some of these here and then add some liquid nitrogen and blend it and then add more and blend it. And
then we have ice cold smoothie.
Yeah, because summer in Finland is really hot. We haven't had any snow in 1 week, so
we need some cold.
Yeah, so let's start with that. Yeah, so first in the ingredient, liquid nitrogen, and we need quite much of this. This is here, and then, yeah, this is working. I toss some bananas, some avocado, some kiwi, and some citrus. Yeah, and I think I take this away, like this, and it's on that direction. And here we go. Let's add more fruits. I put the rest of the fruits in now. Like this. And then this like this. I need to like do some shit. Yeah. And new try. Our blender isn't very good.
Because we are cheap.
Yeah.
It is broken.
Hey. Holy shit. I think we are ready. Yeah. What the fuck? My fruits are frozen. Yeah, I think we wait with this for some time for them to like get free there, and yeah, I think we need a bit better blender, maybe blend tech or something to make this work. Maybe I have to build my own. Yeah, but we don't worry about this, we are going to move on that electric kettle thing. Yep, and then the electric kettle. And I'm going to first fill this up, and then we are going to wait for the whole thing to cool down, and then we are going to switch it on and see how much the nitrogen will start to boil. And it's not wise to stand just next to the table because the glass might break and then the whole thing is going to splash over. And we have still 20% oxygen, so we are safe. Yeah, I think it's time to switch on the power. Let's see. Yeah, now it's on. Somebody can do the calculations, how fast that should boil. I think that has around 2 kilowatts of power. And I have no idea how much it takes to energy to...
What?
It's with... I think it's ready. Let's try again. No.
What the fuck? What happened?
It just switched off. Maybe it's ready. Really strange, because this should switch off when the liquid is like really hot and there is like thermal cutoff, but that's not the case here. So really strange, maybe it's broken. Yeah, seems that the Mokka Master coffee maker is only household machine that can survive the liquid nitrogen. Because this is... Oh no, it's working, okay. Really strange.
I hope explosion.
I am only afraid that we are not going to get any explosions this time. Yeah, now it's really interesting. Because it like... turns itself off. Or maybe I have one like theory behind this, because the liquid nitrogen is so cold, there is constantly like gas layer between the liquid and the bottom of the kettle, and the bottom gets too hot and it thinks that the water is already like boiled, and the liquid nitrogen is just not as good heat transfer than water. I think that is the case here. So quite interesting. Interesting stuff. Because now it's on and now it's off. I'm quite sure that it's the case that... Yeah, now it's on. On. And I get my cup ready. And soon it should be probably, yeah, now it's ready and we can enjoy our... Yeah. Yeah, so you can actually boil liquid nitrogen with electric, just not very good at it. It won't stay on. And seems also that this isn't broken after all this, so we can keep this. Yeah, but that is all for today.
Thank you for watching.
And have a nice day. And for today's extra content, my hand.
Whoa!